Hey everybody, Mr. Graziano again. Here's demonstration number two. I left the sheet there. It's an owl, and I gave the other option of a lemur. You can do either one. So what you're going to be doing with this, very similar to what we did with the shoelaces, with the shoe, is I'm going to be cutting my drawing in half, okay? So I can cut it in half vertically. I can cut it in half horizontally. I can cut it in half diagonally. Doesn't matter, okay? But you're going to replace it with the half that you draw. So here's one that I already cut in half. And I chose to do this owl, so I cut the paper in half. I taped the one side down, and now the other side is right here. And I can do the same thing I did before. So to mark certain spots, if I want to know, okay, where does this eye belong, is I'll hold my pencil, just hover it over the sheet, and then place it, and you can kind of put where that eye is going to be. Now you can see I already started on this drawing. And so what I did is I'm looking at the values once again. You can see this part of the ear very, very, very dark. So it's a very dark value here. You can't really make out any texture here. So I'm going to go over it in multiple directions so that I kind of get rid of the texture. Okay? Remember to keep your pencil sharp because after a while the pencil gets pretty dull. Okay? So what I did is I started putting the values down. So first I drew in the major things like where the eye is, where this white area is right here. So I left that area white. I just stayed out of there. Now up on top of his head, you can see right here, there's a lot of almost like real dark texture and really light texture. So what I did is I put the lighter value down first. Now what you're gonna have to do is kind of experiment is how do I recreate that texture? So when I look at this, I can see there's little like specks here. So I'm gonna come in here and draw those little specks. So I'm gonna do my best to try to duplicate that similar texture. So the point of this assignment is to duplicate texture, okay? Now obviously you don't have to sit here and count every little feather, but you're gonna try to mimic that same sort of texture. And don't think of it as owl feathers. Just kind of say, okay, what are these things? Little specks. They're like little lines here. So I'm working on those textures. You can see this area where the white feathers are. You know, I'm gonna draw into there a little bit because the feathers don't have a smooth edge. It's kind of like they have little parts coming in, but I'm gonna leave that really white. But then in between there, like up here, you can see there's these slashes of black. So I'm gonna start doing that. Now, talk about texture. If you look at the background, the texture is super smooth. So I'm gonna put some texture down, and that's a case where maybe you take your fingers and you sort of smooth that out to get rid of the texture. Okay, now what I want you to do is you're gonna duplicate the whole area, so all the way to the background. So now here, if you look at this part of the owl is light, the texture is dark. So here I put a dark line in, I brought the line in so it disappeared, okay? And then I start adding this texture. And you can see in the background, it's not a solid color, there's light and dark areas. So I'm gonna kinda do some light and dark areas. I'm not super concerned that it's exactly light right here or dark right here. But I'm gonna put these in here. Now the edge of that ear, you can barely see it. That ear is a little darker than the background. So I'm gonna make sure that the ear here is darker than the background, but the background is still pretty dark. So you know, like here the ear might be a value of like 10 and the background is a value of maybe 8 or 9. So it's almost very close. So you'd call that low contrast. There's not much of a difference there between the background and the ear right here. I call it an ear, but you know it's this little feather that sticks up on an owl. So you can see here, he's kind of white around his eyes, so I stayed out of there. Now another thing is, you know, don't be afraid to turn this because if I do have texture, it's gonna go kind of away in the direction of his feathers like here. So like in this area here, you can see the feathers are kind of coming out here. So now I go back with a sharper pencil and I start adding more texture over those feathers to really make it look, you know, textured like that, okay? So just like your other assignment, I want you to duplicate the half that you've removed, okay? The other one was a little window. This is obviously gonna take you longer because it's a much bigger picture. So you got an owl or a lemur right now, okay? The lemur, this area here is a little tricky because he's got a lot of white hairs inside of a dark area. Just make sure that that ear is pretty dark and you can have turn those into little black hairs if you want. Now here with the ear, it's gonna be a little tricky because you're gonna have to bring black lines in between these white lines to make his ear look furry white. Okay, so that is a little tricky, okay? But I'm telling you, if you can do this, there's nothing you can't do when it comes to drawing because these are purposely made to be a little bit difficult, a little tricky. So on future drawings, you don't have problems because you can already do this, something else, no big deal, okay? So go at it. Let's get the owl or the lemur done. Take a picture of it and load it up again into the Google Classroom under your Google Slides. Okay, take care.